Good morning. Today we are going to solve free response question number one from the 2017 AP Physics 1 exam. Bo, please read the problem through part A.
Flippin' physics.
In the three circuits shown, the batteries are all identical and the light bulbs are all identical. In circuit one, a single light bulb is connected to the battery. In circuits two and three, two light bulbs are connected to the battery in different ways as shown. The light bulbs are labeled A through E. Part A, rank the magnitudes of the potential differences across light bulbs A, B, C, D, and E from largest to smallest. If any light bulbs have the same potential difference across them, state that explicitly. And then it says ranking with a space for us to rank the electric potential differences. And then it says, briefly explain how you determined your ranking with a space for that.
Thank you, Bo. Billy, please answer all of part A.
Absolutely. Well, the diagram has those labeled as circuits. However, we usually work with circuit diagrams, and those are just drawings of batteries and light bulbs.
We could draw circuit diagrams for each circuit. That should help.
Good idea. Circuit 1 has one battery and one light bulb. A light bulb is basically a resistor which gives off light, so it's a circuit with one battery and one resistor.
Circuit 2 has one battery and two light bulbs, or resistors. One wire goes from the positive terminal of the battery to light bulb B, and there is a wire from B to C, and then a wire from C to the negative terminal of the battery. Those light bulbs are in series.
Circuit 3 also has one battery and two light bulbs, only the wires are different. In this circuit, wires go from the terminals of the battery to both light bulbs without going through either light bulb. In other words, the light bulbs are in parallel.
Very nice. Billy, please answer part A.
Let's actually start by explaining our ranking. A, D, and E are each connected across the battery, and therefore each has the same electric potential difference as the battery. B and C are in series with the battery, and therefore have an electric potential difference which is less than the electric potential difference across the battery. B and C are identical, and therefore have the same electric potential difference. So we now have our ranking. It is A equals D equals E, which are greater than B, which equals C.
Very nice, Billy. Bo, please also read part B.
Part B. The batteries all start with an identical amount of usable energy and are all connected to the light bulbs in the circuits at the same time. In which circuit will the battery run out of usable energy first? And in which circuit will the battery run out of usable energy last? And there are spots after both of those questions for us to mark which circuit. And then it says, in a clear, coherent paragraph-length response that may also contain equations and drawings, explain your reasoning. Yeah. Okay, so because it says, in a clear, coherent paragraph-length response, this must be the paragraph argument short answer question for this exam.
That is correct, Bo. Bobby, please answer all of part B.
Okay, well, this has to do with electric power, current, and resistance. Again, as pointed out by Billy, a light bulb is basically a resistor which gives off light. Circuit 1 has just one light bulb. Circuit 2 has two light bulbs in series, and circuit 3 has two light bulbs in parallel. Okay, right. The rate at which the battery uses its electric potential energy is electric power. Electric power equals current times electric potential difference. The electric potential differences of all three batteries are the same, so the electric power of each battery is directly proportional to the current delivered by each battery. Considering electric potential difference equals current times resistance, current is inversely proportional to resistance. Therefore, the circuit with the smallest equivalent resistance will have the largest current delivered by the battery and will run out of usable energy first. And the circuit with the largest equivalent resistance will have the smallest current delivered by the battery and will run out of usable energy last. Circuit 3 has two resistors in parallel, and adding a resistor in parallel decreases the equivalent resistance. That means circuit 3 has the smallest equivalent resistance and will run out of usable energy first. Put an X by circuit 3 for that. Circuit 2 has two resistors in series, and adding a resistor in series increases the equivalent resistance. That means circuit 2 has the largest equivalent resistance and will run out of usable energy last. Put an X by circuit 2 for that.
Thank you, Bobby. I have one thing to point out from the scoring guidelines. This question is worth 7 points, and you gain 1 point in Part B for a logical, relevant, and internally consistent argument that addresses the required argument or question asked and follows the guidelines described in the published requirements for the paragraph-length response. Again, please, when they ask for a clear, coherent paragraph-length response, make sure you employ what I describe in my video, qualitative, quantitative translation, and paragraph argument short answer for AP Physics Explained. Also realize you can gain a point for a logical, relevant, and internally consistent argument, even if your conclusions end up being incorrect. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.